A very giant web of a giant supermassive black hole that has been feeding on the gas of six galaxies has been observed by astronomers using ESO's Very Large Telescope. We believe these galaxies to have been trapped in the spider-like web of this giant supermassive black hole. The finding helps to better understand how supermassive black holes, one of which exists at the center of our Milky Way, formed and grew to their enormous sizes so quickly. It also supports the theory that black holes can grow rapidly within large web-like structures, which contain plenty of gas to fuel them, according to the astronomers. So how is it possible? Is it because of dark matter or any other phenomenon? Let's find out. So just sit back and relax and get ready to know more about this strange discovery in this video. Black holes are some of the strangest and most fascinating objects in outer space. They're extremely dense, with such strong gravitational attraction that even light cannot escape their grasp if it comes near enough. Albert Einstein first predicted the existence of black holes in 1916 with his general theory of relativity. The term black hole was coined many years later in 1967 by American astronomer John Wheeler. After decades of black holes being known only as theoretical objects, the first physical black hole ever discovered was spotted in 1971. Since then, black holes have been a center of attraction and research for many astronomers. A black hole is formed when the center of a very massive star collapses in upon itself. This collapse also causes a supernova or an exploding star that blasts part of the star into space. Have you ever wondered if light can escape a black hole? How can we see black holes? Well, we don't see a black hole. We observe the presence of a black hole by its effects on its surrounding. They are very hard to detect in our own galaxy. Then in 2019, the Event Horizon Telescope EHT collaboration released the first image ever recorded of a black hole. The EHT saw the black hole in the center of galaxy M87, while the telescope was examining the event horizon, or the area past which nothing can escape from a black hole. The image maps the sudden loss of photons, particles of light. It also opens up a whole new area of research in black holes, now that astronomers know what a black hole looks like. Black holes are strange and hard to study. There is a good deal of strange that exists in our universe that has been observed by scientists. We already have made a video on the strangest black holes of the universe and also about the first photograph of a black hole. We will leave the link in the description below. Supermassive black holes are one of the most challenging astronomical objects in the universe. Not much is known about them except that they are very huge and are present at the center of every galaxy. Supermassive black holes are extreme systems, and to date we have had no good explanation for their existence. Scientists know little about them. Their formation, and especially their formation in the early universe, is a very intriguing question that scientists look to answer. Our work has placed an important piece in the largely incomplete puzzle that is the formation and growth of such extreme, yet relatively abundant objects so quickly after the Big Bang, said Roberto Gili, an astronomer at INAF in Bologna. It is thought the first black holes, believed to have formed from the collapse of the first stars, must have grown very fast to reach a billion solar masses within the first 900 million years of the universe's life. On top of that, recently astronomers have discovered a half dozen galaxies which formed within the first billion years of the universe, locating a supermassive black hole. The first billion years of the universe were chaotic. We can't look back in time, and in a cosmic sense, Earth is positioned to do so. Because of how long it takes light to travel across the universe, our telescopes can pick up the faint signals of what life was like in the universe's very early days. In the first week of October, astronomers announced the discovery of a massive, intriguing structure from when the universe was just 900 million years old. The structure, about 300 times the size of the Milky Way, contains a supermassive black hole that has ensnared six nearby galaxies in a cosmic spider web of gas. It's shedding new light on how these monstrous beasts of the early universe can grow so rapidly. Astronomers have struggled to understand how supermassive black holes could have formed in the early universe. they know these cosmic Goliaths would have needed to grow extremely fast to achieve their supermassive status so quickly, within about 1 billion years of the Big Bang. But they still don't know where they found out enormous amounts of matter to feed and grow so quickly. But now the new findings from the European Southern Observatory's Very Large Telescope, VLT, may help us find this answer. The six newly discovered galaxies reside within a vast web network of gas, which spans some 300 times the diameter of the Milky Way, and were observed thanks to extended observations by Very Large Telescope, VLT. After analyzing the data, the researchers determined they were seeing these galaxies as they existed just 900 million years after the Big Bang, when the universe was little more than 6% of its current age. This is the first time such a close grouping of galaxies has been found within the first billion years of the universe, and that just continues to put more intriguing and challenging questions for astronomers. And not only this, a supermassive black hole some 1 billion times the mass of the Sun sits at the center of the galactic pit. The original research paper that was published by the scientist states, "We report on the spectroscopic confirmation of a large-scale structure around the luminous Z equals 6.31 quasi-stellar object, QSO, SDSS J103 plus 0524, the name given to this structure, powered by a 1 billion solar mass black hole. The structure is populated by at least six members. These six members are the galaxies caught up in the giant web of the supermassive black hole. The most challenging problem is of the very existence of these supermassive black holes in the early universe. Scientists know that there is a limit to how fast a black hole can grow, the Eddington limit. But while this factor plays a part, scientists cannot understand how these black holes sourced their meals in the first place. In the early universe, there was not much present for these black holes to feed upon and grow as fast as they did. So how is it possible that they exist? Astronomers have struggled to explain how sufficiently large amount of black hole fuel could have been available to enable these objects to grow to such enormous sizes in such a short time. Scientists believe that it has likely to do with the universe's vast cosmic web. Scientists think the universe isn't a random jumble of objects. It has a structure composed of galaxies and gas. Cosmologists call this structure the cosmic web. The cosmic web is composed of interconnecting filaments of clustered galaxies and gases stretched out across the universe and separated by giant voids. Recently, scientists were able to observe this mysterious cosmic web directly for the first time. The observations revealed that an ancient cluster of galaxies about 12 billion light years away in the constellation of Aquarius are linked together by a network of giant gas filaments. The physics of the universe is fascinating, and you might have observed that till now. The newfound structure offers a likely explanation. The web-like structure and the galaxies within it contain enough gas to provide the fuel that the central black hole needs to quickly become a supermassive giant. Using the European Southern Observatory's, ESO's, Very Large Telescope, VLT, in Chile, and telescopes in the US, astronomers examine J1030, which resides in a deep, dark corner of space. The supermassive black hole, which has 1 billion times more mass than our Sun, is huge. And that's unusual because it's also very young. The authors behind the new study think that their supermassive black hole and its surrounding galaxies, dubbed SDSS J1030 plus 0524, likely feed on the gas that was stockpiled in a tangled knot of cosmic web filaments. This research was mainly driven by the desire to understand some of the most challenging astronomical objects, supermassive black holes in the early universe, said Marco Mignoli, an astronomer at the National Institute for Astrophysics, INAF, in Bologna, Italy, in a press release. Several huge black holes have been found in the earliest eras of the universe, but astronomers haven't quite been able to pin down what was enabling them to grow to such mammoth sizes. The cosmic web filaments are like spider's web threads, said Mignoli. The galaxies stand and grow where the filaments cross, and streams of gas available to fuel both the galaxies and the central supermassive black hole can flow along the filaments. But that just pushes the question farther back. How did these filaments first get their gas? Astronomers think the answer might be related to another long-standing astronomical mystery. dark matter. The gigantic structure, the team reasoned, might help feed the black hole with the space food it needs to grow to such large sizes. The finding, the team suggests, provides evidence that dark matter halos, invisible spheres of dark matter, are key to formation of black holes and galaxies in the early universe. It's these halos which provide a type of skeleton where matter like gas collects. The gas flows through this invisible skeleton and eventually falls into the black hole where it gets gobbled up. More gas and galaxies falling into the black hole means a bigger black hole. Scientists think in the very early universe, normal matter was too hot to actually stick together and form gravitationally bound objects such as black holes and galaxies. But researchers think dark matter may have been a lot colder than normal matter. This means dark matter could have clumped together in the early universe, forming giant structures known as dark matter halos. The gravity from these dark structures would have went on to reel in normal matter, attracting enormous amounts of gas that would allow the first galaxies and black holes to take root. There might be other structures like this in other corners of the universe, which might have formed and grown within the most massive dark matter halos. Potentially, many more galaxies reside in the gigantic structure around J1030. We believe we have just seen the tip of the iceberg, and that the few galaxies discovered so far around this supermassive black hole are only the brightest ones, said Barbara Bell Mavert, an astronomer at INAF and co-author of the study. It's hoped the ESO's next-generation telescope, the Extremely Large Telescope, can observe light from faint objects in J0130's vicinity. It's expected to come online in 2025. As already said above, the physics of the universe can be fascinating and mind-boggling. There are still a lot of things that we do not know about in our cosmos. New discoveries are always being made, which refine our perception and understanding of the universe. So what do you think about this intriguing new discovery? Is dark matter the key for us to understand the universe better? What other secrets might this universe be hiding? Let us know your questions and views in the comment section below. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. And press the bell notification to remain notified of amazing videos like this.